I'm gonna now go to my browser because we need a MariaDB database, right? And I can run something quickly on Docker, but I thought, you know what? It's even quicker if I do it with MariaDB Cloud. So it was previously called SkySQL, now it's called MariaDB Cloud, okay? Now let me just continue with my Google account. So it's super simple to get started. I'm gonna close this for now. And then you can launch a free database. Right, so I'm going to click that one. You can deploy the typical MariaDB server with replicas, which is for high availability and read scaling, or you can go with a single node, dedicated node, but I'm going to use this one, serverless. And the reason is because, well, it's super fast to launch and also it's free, so you can try it out. I'm just going to click this, continue, and my database is ready. That was super quick. So now we're going to use a proper ID. This one, Visual Studio Code. So I'm going to create a connection here to MariaDB, and I'm going to use all these connection details. So the host, username, maybe the port, I need that too, and the password. I'm just copy pasting, right, real quick. And the database, well, we'll create one later. We need to activate this thing. That gets configured automatically for you, which is another cool feature of MariaDB. There you go. We have our database connection. Let's create a new database called demo. It has no tables at the moment. So let's create one table because we need a table, right? So create table. We're going to deal with products, like I said at the beginning of this webinar. Products. Let's also use a full text index on name so that we can perform keyword based search. It worked. And now we need to populate this from a file, which I have here. So it's products.csv. Let me show you real quick what this has. So it has the ID, name, category, price, but we're going to use only a name. Okay. And I have something like 500 products here. So for that, we use load data in file, actually local, because it's on my machine. It's not on that machine in the cloud. It's on Deal's machine. So that's where I add local. Then you give the name of the file, but you need to give the full path. So I'm going to copy it from here. There you go. Then, okay, I got some auto-completion here. And I think I would need also enclosed by this character. All right. And we are not going to use the ID. So I'm going to say like here, something like dummy. Okay. Let's see if that works. At least no syntax errors. And the data seems to be loaded correctly. And there are 500 rows here. Okay. We have our data. Now let's code some Python. So again, we have an empty directory here. First, we need a Python environment. Let's use venv. I wonder what was that. Okay. Let's see if this worked. Got activated, and we're going to install some dependencies. So pip install, and I have them here. So MariaDB, we need the integration for LangChain and the Google generative AI integration also for LangChain. And I'm using FastAPI with the standard extras. So we get ubicorn and all the good stuff. Okay. Obviously we can do like a freeze requirements. So we get all the requirements here. Right, so you can see all the stuff that got installed. And that's it. Let's create a main.py file here. We need to define the connection details to our database. So let's say host is going to be, and we have it here. We need probably, yes, the port. The port is this thing. We need, okay, we need the user. The same I did before. In the connection, that was the connection for Visual Studio Code. Now this is for our application, and the database name is demo. This looks good. Now let's create, what can we create here? Well, we need a MariaDB connection. Connection is going to be MariaDB. There you go. Connect. And let's look at the documentation for this. So we have parameters provided as keyword arguments. That is, we need to specify this name. So host, user, password. So it was, I think it was host, and that's the DB host, correct? Actually, it's autocomplete already. So port, user, password, I said I'm gonna use the DB. It's shorter, it's nicer, I think. We have the connection, and I said, let's use SSL, right? SSL equals true, that's all it takes. Good, we're gonna implement this in using SQL, right? SQL text-based search using the full text index that we created when we created the table. So let's create our application, FastAPI application. There you go. And now we're gonna, yes, this works. App.get, let's say products search. Actually, this is like text search. Now, def text search, it takes a, let's call this query as a string. We indeed need a cursor, that's good. Then we need to say cursor.execute. It's actually auto-completing almost correctly. Let me do it this way. It's nicer, I think. Maybe like this, select, never do select star, an actual program, always specify the columns. We're gonna use a name from products, where, not where, order by match. Let's match the name against something. This is the default, so I can just keep it like that. And we need to close this multi-line string properly. So this is gonna get injected here, right? Using this tuple, I guess that's it. Let me format these nicely, and we should return something, right? Return, let's use list comprehension. So I'm gonna return the name for name. I don't need this in cursor, right? So it's basically, this is creating a new list from the result, the rows in cursor, which is whatever this query return. I will need to add a semicolon here. It's not necessary, but for some reason Visual Studio Code doesn't format the code well. Like if I remove it, this doesn't look nice. So let's add it here. And then again, for that, for each row, it's gonna convert into this tuple, which is just has the name. And then we take the name, and it's gonna iterate and create a list with all the names returned by this SQL query. And that's what we're interested in. Now, this is going to return quite a lot of queries, so let's limit to 10. How do I run this? I think we can use just FastAPI development mode and the name of our Python program. Well, at least it seems to have worked all right. Let's open this Swagger interface, which is automatically created for us. And we have this endpoint, get products text search. So let's try it out. Let's say we want running shoes, execute, and all right, it works. That's very nice. So we got some product names here. Okay, back to our program. Now let's try to implement this using vector search. For this, we need a vector store. So vector store is going to be a MariaDB store. This comes from the integration for LangChain. And if we check the documentation here, we see that we need an embedding subject. That's our embedder, our AI model, right? And that's going to be the Google Generative AI embeddings. So let's see what this needs. It needs a model name as a string and the Google API key, which I defined already. But let's go with model equals, and I don't remember, so, but I know Google Generative AI embeddings documentation has the name somewhere here. And we should say here, hey, this is the actual embeddings object. Okay, very good. Now it's gonna read the this environment variable, which I already defined in my operating system. You have to believe me. You have to trust me on that one, Google API key. Let's do a multi-line thing here. We also need to configure the length, okay? So let's do that. We need to say length, and I don't remember that one. I think somewhere here it says, okay, here. So all models produce full length embedding vector by default for this one, which is the one we're using, has these dimensions. Okay, so that's where I want it. Done. What else do we need? We probably need, of course, a data source. We need to connect to MariaDB, right? Or the MariaDB store needs to connect to MariaDB. So we need to provide a data source. And if you look at it, it can be a SQL Alchemy engine or a connection string. So we're going to use MariaDB with the MariaDB connector. And I believe this looks all right. Now, password. Yeah. So password has this character here. So it's a special character. And this is an URL, right? So we need to quote this using this function over here so that it gets encoded correctly. And also, before I forget, SSL equals true. What else do we need? We probably want to specify the collection name. This is like an identifier for collection. Collection is a set of vector embeddings that are related. And there's also collection metadata where we can store some other stuff like the model that we use, where the information came from. For now, I'm just going to use something like, these are the product names. We can use whatever we want there. This should be enough for now. And now we can define, we can implement the endpoint. So of course we need the vectors. We don't have vectors. Where are the vectors, right? So let's do a post. Let's call this ingest. Okay, we're going to ingest the products. We need the cursor. We need to select the names from products because we are going to create one vector per each name. And then this is telling me to get the products like this. I think that's pretty good. It's actually what I would like to do. And then we use the vector store to add texts, these products. So we get all the names from the products table, and then we create a list of those names, and then we add those there. And just for simplicity, I wouldn't do this in production in real code, but let's do it like this. Then we can return ingestion complete. That looks good to me. So let's try that out. All right, application startup completed. Now if I refresh this, we should get our endpoint post ingest. Okay, let's try it out and see what happens. Let's check the log here. No errors. So it must be working. So it's sending all the product names to Google Generative AI. And this huge model is calculating the vectors. And then the vector store is going to store those vectors somewhere that I'm going to show you in a moment. Ingestion complete. Nice. Now let's go to a database and refresh this. So as you can see, the MariaDB integration created two more tables. LangChain collection, and it's going to use this product names. Let's check that out. So we have one collection with the label that we configured, and it has an ID 0199. Okay. Now the other table, let's close this, is a LangChain embedding, and it has 500 rows because we calculated a vector for each product. As you can see, it has, first of all, each row has a collection ID 0199. So it's using that collection ID here, like one too many. And then you have the content, or page content is called in LangChain, with the actual name of the products, which is what we sent to the LLM, and the actual embedding here. And it's in binary format, but we can use MariaDB's VectToText function to see these as numbers. There you go. We got our embeddings. Now, what's the point of having these embeddings? The point is that now we can actually perform vector search. We're going to use a get endpoint, and we're going to call this vector search. We're going to receive a query as a string. We're going to use the vector store and call the similarity search method. There are other methods if you want to explore. We pass this, and I believe we can say k equals 10, which is the number of results to return. We want 10, as we did here. Now this returns, if we have a look at this, this returns a list of documents. So we have a document. Okay, there we go. The AI helped us. So we're gonna take the results, and each row or each element in that list is a document. And we're gonna take the page content, which again is just this part here, content. Okay, encode is code page content. I guess that's it. So one and two lines, basically, to actually implement this. Not bad at all. Ooh. Let's see if we have any errors. No errors. Let's refresh. And now we should have our endpoint here, vector search. So let's try it out. running shoots, execute. I think these are better already, but let's use exactly the same query here in the text search, and let's compare these elements. But let's use Gemini for that. So I'm gonna copy this one, and I'm gonna say wish. Let me zoom in for you. Wish result set gave better results for the search query running shoes. Result set one is this. Result set two, this is the one with AI, which is here, vector search. Let's see what Gemini thinks. Result set two gave better results for the search query running shoes. So yeah, the AI has spoken and we have used it for evaluating this. This is how simple it is to interact with LLMs, with LangChain, and especially with the integration for MariaDB, which makes it super easy, one line of code to implement this. If you want to learn more about all things MariaDB, I'm writing a new book. So go to MariaDBfordevelopers.com. Just open a new tab in your browser and go there if you're interested. Scroll down that page. And if you like what you see, sign up for a notification for when the book is ready.